I'll be showing you a whole shoulder of lamb in a delicious Indian spiced marinade, slow cooked until gorgeously tender, and serving it with an incredible barbecue green bean and coconut side dish. One of my favorite cuts of meat of all time ever is a shoulder of lamb. Like all of the cuts of meat I'll be cooking, this has to be slow cooked.
You do not want it pink. It will be tough. If you think it spends all day walking around a field, that slower cooking breaks all those sinews down and will ensure fantastic flavor.
I'm taking inspiration from a part of the world that has some incredible lamb dishes.
Indian cookery has got a huge tradition of food being cooked in coals or clay ovens, that kind of raw, natural heat that works so well with slow roasting and spiced meats.
I'll be using different techniques to prepare my three joints before cooking. First up is a gorgeous spiced yoghurt marinade.
The great thing about lamb is it can take so many spices and added flavors.
The yoghurt's acidity tenderizes the meat. When I increase the heat at the end of cooking, it forms a lovely crust.
Yogurt's used in Indian cookery so much, and it helps to kind of bind and mix all of the ingredients together. I've got here tandoori curry powder.
I love a bit of heat, so I'm adding some dried chili flakes, then some salt.
A great big knob of fresh ginger. You can grate it or you can chop it like this.
Then a load of grated garlic.
The longer that you cook things, particularly with spices like this, the softer they become. It's not such a raw, strong, harsh flavor.
And just to bring it all together, some distilled vinegar.
And vinegar using with spice mix into Indian cookery is not unusual. That acidity, it works so well with the spices. And now I'm gonna rub in this marinade. Make sure you get it right deep into the meat and into those cuts. The bone being in the shoulder of lamb helps to ensure moisture staying in there.
Ideally, I'd leave this to marinate in the fridge overnight.
The longer you leave it in that marinade, the better, the more it kind of absorbs and takes on all of those flavors. But I'm just gonna get this straight onto the barbecue.
Sliced onions will form the perfect bed for my lamb to cook on.
These onions will caramelize and soften up, and there'll be little crispy bits and burnt bits and juicy bits. And then into the onions, I'm gonna pour 1 pint of water. Lamb sits on top of the onions. Now this tin foil is gonna act as the lid. There's also the pint of water in there, and that will come up to the boil and that will steam. So this lamb is almost like braising. It's kind of like a lamb casserole. It's just gonna be cooked on the barbecue. This is at 150 degrees centigrade. It's got the convection plate in it that will help distribute the heat evenly.
All of these slow cooked dishes can be made in any barbecue with a lid. You don't want the coals too hot, and you may need to add some more during cooking.
I'm gonna cook it for around about 4.5 hours, which gives me enough time to go and walk the dogs, watch 2 football matches, do a bit of washing up. Smell them. The coals is absolutely amazing. But also the lamb is incredible.
To make my lamb char grilled, I need to get the temperature right up. So I'm opening the vents on my barbecue to get lots of oxygen flowing through.
The lamb is cooked. It's all flaking away from the bone. But I just want to get a bit of a crust on it now.
Barbecue temperature is up. Back in goes the lamb.
Gonna crisp that up for about, I reckon, 10 to 15 minutes. Hot, spicy, and the smells that are coming from that, fantastic.
My delicious, rich lamb needs something fresh to go alongside it. And I've got just the thing, my fantastic coconut green beans.
I'm gonna put a couple of tablespoons of ghee, which is essentially clarified butter. And I'm gonna put into it some fresh curry leaves, and they taste amazing. And they work so well with these black mustard seeds.
adding a little touch of ground turmeric for colour.
And into that, I'm going to put some of these. Now, these are French beans that have just been blanched.
I've got some desiccated coconut that I've soaked in some water.
And then I'm going to turn the beans around. And the moment that all the coconut started to absorb that lovely turmeric, ready to serve up.
Time for the final touches.
I'm going to use two forks. Look how easy that comes away from the bone. Just let it fall into those rich, caramelized onions. But when you can, just remove the bone. Look how easy that was, that slow cooking. The meat is just falling apart. Look at that. That is super special. It's all cooked on a barbecue. How cool is that?
Vibrant coconut green beans and a yoghurt and mint dressing make this a beautifully balanced dish.
The lamb is so beautiful. It's tender. It's delicious. The flavours you get from slow cooking. But do you know what? Doing it on a barbecue just enhances everything. The depth of smoky, charcoal-y, roasted. Everything you expect from cooking outdoors or on coals. Delicious.